everyone, it's Katrina. From rare whales that are hardly ever seen to incredibly unique hybrids, here are 9 whales you've probably never heard of. Number 9. The Minke Whale Hybrid. There are 2 species of Minke whales that literally live on opposite sides of the globe, the Antarctic Minke in the south and the Northern Minke in the Arctic. But it turns out that somehow these whales from polar opposite ends of the planet have come together and created a hybrid. Researchers took samples from a pregnant female Minke whale captured in the North Atlantic. These whales have been hunted extensively since the 1930s, and it's kind of a miracle that there are any left. DNA analysis showed that the whale fetus had the genetic blueprint of a hybrid. Both Minke species reach up to 35 feet long and migrate seasonally to equatorial waters. While their territory overlaps here, each species migrates at different times of the year, since the seasons are opposite between the two hemispheres. Because of this, scientists long believed that it wasn't even really possible for the Northern Minke whales and Antarctic Minke whales to cross paths. But the newly discovered hybrid proves that their initial suspicions were wrong. The creature in question was killed in 2007, and its DNA was registered as part of Norway's ongoing efforts to ensure that whales are hunted legally. When geneticist Kevin Glover noticed the hybrid's unusual genetic information, he remembered a story someone had told him years earlier about an unusual-looking whale being spotted in 1996. It didn't have the white patch on its pectoral flippers like the Northern Minke whales do, Glover told National Geographic. He began wondering if the creature was a hybrid like the one he found a record of and analyzed its DNA, only to discover that it was entirely an Antarctic whale. The takeaway from this study is that, much to scientists' surprise, that Antarctic Minke whales sometimes travel all the way to the Northern Minke whales' range, and that they even occasionally breed. Whether contact between these species represents a new phenomenon due to lack of food in the Antarctic ecosystem, or has occurred at a low frequency over many years, is still a mystery. Number 8. Type D Orca. In early 2019, a team of scientists identified and studied a group of mysterious killer whales living in the Southern Ocean, in some of the world's harshest known conditions. They look distinctively different from other orcas, with a more rounded head, a narrower and pointier dorsal fin, and an unusually small white eye patch, according to National Geographic. This population, which the researchers observed roughly 60 miles off the coast of Cape Horn, Chile, is highly likely to be a previously unidentified species. Known as Type D, or subantarctic killer whales, they were only ever known from photographs, descriptions, and a mass stranding, with no professional observations to speak of until recently. For the study, the team traveled to an area where fishermen had spotted the animals. After waiting for over a week, a pod numbering over 25 whales appeared. The scientists took a blubber and skin sample for DNA analysis. In early 2020, a British Columbia-based scientist named Josh McInnes had the privilege of observing Type D orcas firsthand during a 3-week National Geographic expedition to Antarctic waters. McInnes and the crew he was traveling with spotted the rare whales in the Drake Passage, which is infamous for harboring some of the world's roughest seas. As a lifelong orca enthusiast and scholar, he immediately recognized the creatures as Type D killer whales. For McInnes, seeing what he calls the rarest marine mammal on the planet came as a complete shock. "That was one animal I dreamed of seeing, but probably thought I'd never see them," he told Global News. In addition to seeing the scarce species in the first place, the team also observed the Type D orcas interacting with other whale species. They noticed a conspicuous lack of aggression between the two, which is contrary to the norm when it comes to marine mammals encountering killer whales, indicating to McInnes that perhaps the suspected new species dines on fish rather than other mammals. Orcas are notorious for eating whale calves. This was the most southerly instance of scientists seeing the subantarctic orca. According to the most recent update, researchers are still analyzing DNA samples of the newly discovered Type D orcas to confirm that they constitute a separate species from other killer whales. Number 7. True's Beaked Whale. Beaked whales constitute one of the least understood groups of mammals. The True's Beaked Whale is one of the rarest species of all. These marine creatures are difficult to spot, let alone study, because they live in extremely deep waters. What we know about them is mostly from strandings, and the handful spotted alive at sea have been alone or in very small groups. In early 2014, New England Boating reported that a jogger on Long Island, New York, encountered what looked like a dead dolphin in shallow water along the coast. He contacted the Riverhead Foundation for Marine Research and Preservation, which responds to whale strandings in the area, and provided cell phone pictures of the creature, which measured 14 feet long. Immediately upon seeing the photos, the organization's rescue program director, Kimberly Durham, knew that the animal was not a dolphin. She identified it as a true beaked whale and reached out to other whale specialists and organizations, including the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution, giving them a rare opportunity to study the enigmatic species. While conducting a survey in late 2019, volunteers from the nonprofit ORCA snapped pictures of a pod of four true beaked whales in the Bay of Biscay in the Northeast Atlantic Ocean. It was the first confirmed sighting of the species in the region, and the photographic evidence showed that one of the whales, a male, appeared to have two extra teeth. Discoveries like this show just how little experts know about beaked whales in general, including, and perhaps especially, the true beaked whale. Number 6. Dolphin whale hybrid. According to a 2018 report, scientists from the U.S. Navy-funded Cascadia Research Collective Marine Mammal Monitoring Program have identified a rare dolphin whale hybrid off the Kauai coast in the Hawaiian Islands. After tagging several cetaceans in 2017, they noticed that one creature looked unlike any known species. It had the dorsal fin of a melon-headed whale with a sloped head that more closely resembled a rough-toothed dolphin, as well as blotchy pigmentation. DNA analysis revealed the creature as the first known offspring of a melon-headed whale and a rough-toothed dolphin. This unique genetic combination was possible because melon-headed whales are actually from the oceanic dolphin family, which includes orcas and two pilot whale species. The researchers pointed out that the hybrid specimen does not represent a new species and is so far only known as an isolated case. The team noticed that the hybrid was traveling with a melon-headed whale and saw the pair associating with rough-toothed dolphins. This entire scenario is a bit strange, considering that 1) this was the first known sighting of a melon-headed whale in the immediate area, and 2) melon-headed whales are known to congregate in groups of 200 to 300 members, not in small pairs. It is most likely the melon-headed whale is its mother who has joined the pod of dolphins. The Cascadia Research Collective is hoping that they are able to find the pair again to see how this curious hybrid came to be. Number 5. North Pacific Right Whale. No thanks largely to commercial whaling, the North Pacific right whale was nearly wiped from existence during the mid-19th century. Today, it is the rarest large whale species, with an estimated population in the double digits. While North Pacific right whales often came into close contact with humans who were hunting them, scientists have had far less interactions with the species, and we know very little about them. They are rarely seen today, with just a handful of confirmed sightings over the last several decades. Researchers do know that the whale is a baleen species that feeds on krill and small fish, that it grows between 45 and 64 feet long, and that it can weigh up to 100 tons. The most recent confirmed sighting of a North Pacific right whale happened in 2013 near Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. Scientists observed the 52-foot-long specimen among a group of humpback whales over a several-day span. Although the whaling industry is far less of an issue now than it used to be, human activity continues to threaten the North Pacific right whale. Entanglement in fishing gear, vessel strikes, climate change, and underwater noise all pose ongoing hazards to this critically endangered species. Number 4. The narwhal. While you've probably already heard of narwhals, the more you learn about them, the more mysterious they become. Nicknamed the unicorn of the sea, this Arctic Ocean-dwelling species is best known for the 6 to 9 foot-long tusk that protrudes from the skulls of male specimens. No other animal on Earth has this feature or anything remotely like it. The narwhal's unicorn horn is actually a giant tooth that sticks out through the head from the animal's upper lip, always spiraling in a counterclockwise direction. It sprouts from the left side of the whale's mouth and is paired with a much more normal tooth that remains embedded in the creature's jaw. Once in a great while, both teeth erupt as tusks, but one is always longer. This asymmetry is a one-of-a-kind example in nature. Meanwhile, narwhals have no teeth inside their mouth. Scientists are unsure what they use their tusks for. They believe it may play a role in mating since it's a predominantly male feature. Size matters in the animal kingdom, and females may judge a potential mate's suitability based on how big his tusk is, or isn't. Oddly, however, female narwhals also sometimes develop a tusk, throwing an unexpected twist into this theory. This not only complicates the idea of narwhals using their tusk for mating, it obstructs the notion that tusks may have evolved for use in male-to-male combat. At the same time, other signs, including broken tusks and forehead scars, point towards fights between narwhals. It's also possible that the appendage helps them detect prey and with sensing their surroundings. Narwhals use echolocation and produce about 1,000 clicks per second, and scientists used to believe their long tooth helped them with that. But those that don't have the tusk are also just as able to use echolocation. Drone footage captured in 2017 might provide the best evidence thus far. In the clip, narwhals use their tusk to pierce and stun prey, indicating that it is most likely a hunting weapon. This is the first ever video of the animals actually using their horns, and serves as a major turning point in the lingering mystery. Number 3. Blue whale and fin whale hybrid. A whale that was killed off the coast of Iceland in 2018 made headlines when conservationists expressed concern that it may be a member of the protected blue whale species. Images of the gargantuan creature being butchered circulated online, sparking outrage and demands for answers among activists. At first glance, some researchers suspected that the animal was a young male blue whale. DNA tests later confirmed that it was the very rare offspring of a female blue whale and a male fin whale. A flu whale? A blin? I don't know what you call it. The unique hybrid's conservation status is controversial. Both blue whales, which were hunted nearly to extinction at one point, and fin whales are afforded the highest protection available via an International Whaling Commission worldwide moratorium on whale hunting that went into effect in 1982. While Iceland respects the blue whale's protected status, it disagrees that fin whales are a threatened species and issues hunting permits for them. Hybrid whales are uncommon in the waters off Iceland, with only 5 being recorded since 1983, according to Astrid Fuchs from the nonprofit Whale and Dolphin Conservation, who spoke with the BBC. The company responsible for the animal's death said that it knew all along that the creature was a hybrid, not a blue whale, and defended its alleged right to kill it. Animal advocates stand firm in their stance that it was still wrong to kill the whale, and are using its death as an example of why they believe whale hunting should end altogether in Icelandic waters. Once the whale was verified as a hybrid, its meat could not legally be shipped anywhere, including to Japan, Iceland's top whale meat customer. Meanwhile, the whale hunters suffered no major repercussions due to the gray area of the animal's conservation status. Number 2. Spade-toothed whale. The spade-toothed whale is the rarest of the 21 beaked whale species. It was first identified based on a partial jaw that washed ashore in New Zealand in 1872. Partial skulls were subsequently found in 1950 and 1986. Nobody witnessed a spade-toothed whale firsthand until December 2010, when two of the creatures were found on Opabe Beach in New Zealand. Both died before staff members from the Department of Conservation arrived at the scene. At first, they thought that the pair were gray-beaked whales, a species that commonly becomes stranded in the region. But much to the researchers' surprise, a DNA analysis proved that the duo were actually spade-toothed whales. Since only bones were ever found until then, this marked the first time scientists finally knew what the species looks like. Advanced DNA technology has helped to simplify the process of identifying similar-looking whale species, and New Zealand's highly efficient system of reporting and responding to whale strandings has yielded over 2 decades' worth of records detailing rare species. Many unanswered questions continue to surround the elusive spade-toothed whale. Because they are so rarely seen, scientists don't know how many are left or how endangered they are. It's possible that these mysterious marine mammals dwell primarily in deep waters, making encounters with humans unlikely. But like many cetaceans, they could also be threatened. Number 1. The narluga. Narwhals are strange enough on their own, but things got even weirder in 2019, when a shocking study documented one known instance of the so-called unicorn of the sea breeding with a beluga. The finding is based on a bizarre whale skull that an Inuit hunter donated to the Natural History Museum of Denmark in 1990. It belonged to one of 3 strange whales the man hunted off Greenland's western coast during the mid-80s. The creatures had beluga-like pectoral fins and tails that more closely resembled the narwhal. The skull's lower jaw contains odd-looking pointed teeth, is larger than the skull of either a beluga or a narwhal, and just looks super weird, in the words of lead study author Aline Lorenzen. Scientists compared DNA from the skull's teeth with the teeth of 8 belugas and 8 narwhals, and the results were nothing short of shocking. The specimen in question appears to be 54% beluga and 46% narwhal, proving definitively for the first time that the two species have, in fact, interbred. Furthermore, evidence suggests that the creature was a male and that his mom was a narwhal. Whether you prefer to call it a narluga or a belwhal, this one-of-a-kind example of the beluga-narwhal hybrid is quite fascinating. At the same time, the discovery is not as surprising as it seems. Narwhals are known to occasionally travel with beluga pods and vice versa, and hybridization between whale species in general is not uncommon. As climate change worsens and Arctic sea ice continues to melt, experts speculate that we may see more examples of whales interbreeding. They are currently examining bones dating back as far as 50,000 years in an effort to identify prior examples of this happening. Thanks for watching! Which whale was your favorite? Do you like the rare whales or the hybrids? If you'd like to learn more about strange and unique animals, let me know in the comments below. Remember to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time. Bye!